Hi, my name is Ryan and I'm a law student at SMU. However, breeding birds is my hobby and welcome to our bird farm.
Okay, so Ryan, what's so special about these peacocks?
Well, these are Burmese peacocks and they're different from the peacocks that run around Sentosa. Instead of them being blue, these peacocks are green and gold. They are very rare birds and they are from Burma in Cambodia and they are worth a lot of money. While the usual peacocks are blue and have a white face, these peacocks are green and gold and have a yellow facial patch. It is also very interesting for this particular species.
The female's pretty too.
The female is pretty too, exactly. Yeah. Because the female blue peafowl that you see on Sentosa are primarily brown in colour.
Yeah.
These are beautiful in green and gold. We currently have this pair and there's another younger pair behind and we're hoping to breed them. We're trying to do conservation in that particular way.
So what is this enclosure for?
Well, this enclosure is for the common or blue crown pigeons. They are a species of pigeons from Papua New Guinea. Mm-hmm. And they look like dodos. They are ground pigeons. They have big bodies. And they spend most of their lives on the ground. However, in the night, they do nest in trees and have their eggs and babies in trees. They were almost hunted to extinction because Victorian ladies like to adorn their hats with the plumes on the heads of these little pigeons. They foolishly are tame. Wild birds are also quite tame because they have no natural predators in New Guinea, so the hunters are just caught them.
So why are their tails moving about so fast?
That's how they communicate. Different species of crown pigeons have different markings on their tails. Some of them have a white band, so that's very obvious in the darkness of the forest where the light reflects against on the white.
Mm-hmm.
And they communicate with each other by the rhythmic up and downward movement of the tail. So they're probably saying that they got some strangers in their house.
You're like, ah! Who are they?
You see, they're so trusting, they're coming so near. They were easy targets.
And these are actually really young.
These are about 4 to 5 months old and they were hand-fed by us at the farm.
So Ryan, where are you going now?
I'm going to take you to one of the big aviaries to look at the bigger birds, parrots. We're going to look at some birds with hooked bills.
Now, how many types of birds do you actually have here on the farm?
Probably over 100, 200 species. Last count. We do have records, but I don't have them on hand. We're in the big aviary at the farm where we keep most of the large parrots.
How many, like, parrots do you have in place like that?
I think we have about over 100 pairs. They're all kept in pairs, in individual cages for each pair. So we're going to take you around and we're going to have a look at the parrots.
Yeah. So this is actually for them to breed?
Yes. In fact, in every cage, there's a box behind for them to make their nest. It's called a nest box.
So,
a wooden box.
That's where they have sexy time together.
Okay, this particular species is called the Eclectus parrot. They're sexually dimorphic, which means that the male and female look different. And you can tell immediately. For years and years, scientists and people, taxonomists, have described the male and female of this particular species as different species. So they were trying to breed 2 green ones and 2 red ones. In fact, the males are green, females are red.
Hey, this looks like a very unusual parrot.
Yes, this is the Pescet's parrot or the Voucherine parrot from Papua New Guinea. They are the only frugivorous parrot, which means that they only eat fruit and not seeds like the other parrots. So it has a bare facial patch such that fruit and the sticky fruit will not get stuck on its feathers. They're hunted heavily in Papua New Guinea.
So very rare?
Yes, the native tribes like them because they have broad tail feathers and also nice red feathers which they put on their head pieces. And these are black crown cockatoos. They're critically endangered. And we've got the biggest collection in the world here at this farm. The interesting thing is that these birds cannot close their mouth. That's how they evolve. They're from Papua New Guinea. The male is bigger than the female. He's tilting his head back. They have somewhat of a mating dance where they tilt their head back and they tap their feet.
Well, this isn't Discovery Channel, but it sure feels like it. Meanwhile, would you pay $30,000 for a parrot? Stay tuned.